Welcome to the session, Learn and Teach Management and Leadership using Games and Exercises, the M.M. Patel Way. Today's exercise is making garlands of inflated balloons. The learning objectives are resource identification, work content estimation, process planning, and production line balancing. Let us discuss the exercise. For this game, you will be needing some material. The materials are balloons which can be inflated beyond 6 inches length and strong enough thread for tying up balloons. The quantity required shall depend on the number of teams. Now let us discuss the task and the conditions. The participants shall be divided in the teams of 5 to 6. The team shall be given balloons and a piece of thread. The teams are required to inflate the balloons minimum 6 inches long and firmly tie the balloons at a distance of approximately 6 inches to make the garland having maximum number of balloons in 5 minutes time. The balloons are to be procured by the teams at a rate of rupee 1 each and the thread at a rate of rupee 1 per foot, that is 12 inches. The leftover material after the exercise is over shall not be taken back. Leftover material and deflated balloons shall be the loss of the team. The garlands can be sold at a rate of rupees 2 per balloon in the garland. There is a penalty provision also. A penalty of rupee 1 each for deflated balloons, balloons less than 6 inches length and loosely tied balloons in the garland shall be levied. This means the teams will have to ensure proper inflation of the balloons and tying up the balloons on the threads properly at required distance. The teams have 15 minutes time to discuss and plan. For deciding the process and estimating the quantity of balloons and threads they need to purchase, each team shall be given 2 balloons and a foot long thread free of cost. The teams can use 2 balloons and a foot long thread during discussion period. They can inflate the balloons, they can decide the tying up process, and they can experiment with 2 balloons and a foot long thread. This material should be returned. That means during the exercise, this material will not be used. After 15 minutes, the materials asked for by the teams shall be supplied to each team. They will start together at announced time. The time spent shall be announced by the trainer every 30 seconds. Let the team tell how much profit they have made once the exercise is over. The following is the format for the profit compilation. Sales less penalty will give net sales, less cost of balloons and less cost of thread will give net profit. Once the exercise is over, the profits by each team shall get compiled. Each team will come to know how much profit they have made and how much profit other teams have made. Naturally, there will be differences. And these differences will lead to the discussion. How much was the profit planned? How much profit is made? The variation and reasons of variation. Did the team identify the resource for inflating the balloons? Remember, the teams had been given 2 balloons. Now naturally, they should have found out during discussion period who is having expertise for inflating the balloons. Did they identify the resource for tying the balloons? Did the team decide the process of measuring inflated balloons and the distance? Was the time estimation perfect? Was the planning for first 30 seconds in place to avoid idle time of members during initial period? Was the planning for last 30 seconds in place to avoid idle time and to have minimum possible leftover? Was their working balanced throughout? That means no member was idle at any point of time or the idleness was for minimum seconds. And finally, how the learning shall be made use of at their working place. This is very important. This exercise is not about inflating the balloons. This exercise is about resource identification and optimum resource utilization to get maximum efficiency. Making garland of inflated balloons. Let us revisit the learning planned. Resource identification and utilization. Work content estimation. The job of a supervisor, the job of a leader primarily is to work content estimation. If you fail in work content estimation, your planning will not take place properly. When the work is in process, if at that point of time you realize that your estimation was wrong, you will have to make a lot of adjustments. And therefore, our primary job is to estimate work content and to estimate accurately. The next, process planning and production line balancing. I am sure you must have liked the exercise and would like to include in your KT. Thank you. Thanks a lot. See you again in the next session. Thank you.